he wishes, he will advise you on what was contained in what I handed over to him. Probably I will give a little peek when you got the bottle.
The handover ceremony, which was attended by the shadow cabinet ministers and other opposition legislators, started from the leader of opposition's office, where outgoing leader of opposition Mathias Mpuuga handed over instruments including files and the official seat of the leader of opposition before proceeding to the boardroom for speeches. Senyonyi noted that his agenda will not differ much from Mpuuga's climax, as the fight against violation of human rights will top his menu.
We have been through and continue with the issue of human rights violations. Ugandans want justice, and they're counting on you and I to be their voice for that justice. People lost their loved ones through the election period. Many others are in jail.
The NUP spokesperson gave confidence to the public that expects much from the opposition, that they will do everything possible to live up to the billing. He called for support from his colleagues for the good of the opposition.
Seems to be a lot of excitement about this particular change of leadership, this particular transition. And really, it dawned on me that the excitement is because Ugandans rarely see a peaceful change of guard. Rarely does it happen, you know. Normally there's pulling of ropes here and there, and then there's places where it has not even happened at all. And so that's why maybe there's a bit of excitement. So it should be a good thing that we are sending a signal that it is possible.
Senyonyi also shed light on the position of the deputy chief whip that had been given to the Mityana municipality legislator Francis Zake, but rejected by the Speaker of Parliament Anita Among on grounds that it is non-existent in the law.
The office of the deputy chief opposition whip, by the way, has not just started. It was there even in the last parliament. It's not within the rules, but it was created to ease work, to lessen the load on the chief opposition whip, for work to continue happening. It was an internal creation. It was an internal creation by the opposition, and it is something we found fit to carry on, and we'll carry on with that responsibility. So yes, it might not be known within the structures of parliament. That's okay.
The outgoing leader of opposition, now the parliamentary commissioner, Mathias Mpuuga Nsamba, pledged to give support to the incoming leader of opposition, Joel Senyonyi.
I would like to disagree with Honorable Joyce when she says that she wants you to treat Honorable Joel the way you treated me. No, I invite you to treat him even much better than he have done. You know, it shouldn't be the same. It can be better. You know, it's been a learning and unlearning process between us. And I'm very sure we have learned a lot from each other.
He also extended caution to his successor to balance interests of all political parties in the opposition, since his jurisdiction extends beyond NOP. Mpuuga made it clear to Senyonyi that his challenges will not only be the government, but even fellow legislators in opposition who will backstab him.
Alive to the destructions from within, including from people who are supposed to back you up. You don't need to have the strength to work with the people who are supposed to back you up, but instead choose to backstab you. Be strong. There's a job to do for the party, for the country, for history. I know you'll be capable of doing that. I want to wish you the best.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.